So welcome everyone, and this is Venu, and you are watching Streetlight Academy C programming videos. So the topics we are going to discuss in this class is the first one is simple if statement. We can also call it is a one-way decision, if else statement, it is two-way decision, nested if else, else if ladder, and switch statements. So all these are combinedly called as control flow statement. So the concept, today concept is, it is about control flow statements in C language. Okay. So actually what is mean by control flow statements? The control flow statements means here control, generally control is called flow of execution. The control is called flow of execution, and the control flow statements are nothing but we can also call the control flow statements are your branching statements and decision making statements also we can call. So why it is a decision making statement? Based on the decision, the some statements can be executed and some may be skipped. So that is why it is called a decision making statement. And sometimes we can also call the conditional statement and the selection statements. Okay, all these are having the same name here: control flow statements, branching, decision making, conditional statements, selection statements. All examples are these only, these five statements. Okay, then what is the need of control flow statement here? The need of control statements is this here. So using control flow statements, we can change the sequential order of execution of the program here. So generally the C program is execution, it starts from main section onwards, and after main section it will execute all the statements one after the other. That means sequentially it is executed, but I want to change those order. So that is with the help of a control flow statements. Let us see what are the several control flow statements are here. The first type is called simple if statement. Second one is if else, nested if else, else if ladder, and final one is switch statement. Simple if statement means it is also called one-way decision statement. If else is two-way decision, else if ladder multi-way decision. So why it is called simple if means what? It's based on only one decision. It's the statements are executed based on one decision. That is why it is called one-way decision. And what about in the case of if else? The statements are executed based on the two decisions. If the condition is true, some statements are executed. Otherwise, condition is false, also some statements are executed. That is why it is two-way. And what about else if ladder? In the case of else if ladder, so based on various conditions, based on various conditions, we can execute the statement. So that is why it is called multi-way decision statement. Multi-way decision statement. And let us see all these here one by one from simple if statement onwards. And if you observe your simple if statement, the if statement, it is test the condition. If the condition is true, it exclude the block. Otherwise, it skip the block. That's all. Okay. If condition is true, it executed that block. See. So if you observe here the syntax, if is the keyword and followed by some text expression or condition, and if this expression is true, the statement is executed. So in this case, I'm executing only one statement, but I want to execute more than one statement. Then you can use this open and close braces. Here, open and close braces, it is represented as compound statement. Compound means what? There is a situation to execute more than one statement, use open and close braces. It represents a compound. Okay. The thing is that how the simple if statement will work here. If condition is true, statements are executed. If condition is false, statements are skipped. That's all. Okay. So now if you see the flowchart of this simple F statement, so condition, if it is true, then cursor will be reached after the true block statement, then it executed the remaining statement after the if. So otherwise, if it is false, means what? It can skip those statement it is, and now it is reached to the end of the if. Okay, end of the simple if statement. So what is the drawback with this simple if statement here? When condition is false, it's not perform any operation, it's not perform any action. So that is why this is the drawback of simple if statement here. If condition is true only, we can perform some action, perform some operations. If condition is false, it's not perform any operation, any task. Let us see the example. So here I have to read one number n, and I have to find out the number is positive or negative. So first of all, I have to read the number. Enter the number, and after then I'm reading the number. Now here, if this number is greater than 0, okay, so I'm saying that if the number which is greater than 0 means it is positive number. So I'm writing it is positive number. Okay, that's all. And now after this, it is the normal statement. Just I am writing it is a normal statement, like I am writing end of the program. Just I am writing. So now here, if the whatever the value we are reading here, if this is true only, the statement is executed. If this is false, means what? Immediately cursor is come to the next line of the program here. So 10th line indicates here next line of the program. So I am compiled. I have to run the code here. So I'm giving 12. So now 12 is, what we get here, 12 is positive number and end of the program. This is the normal flow of the program, and this statement is based on the condition here. If this condition is true only, this statement is display here, positive number. Okay, but see, if I am giving, suppose input, if I am giving input like minus 12, I am giving. So now here also it is not satisfied. Why? If I am giving minus 12 means what? Condition is false here. The condition minus 12 is greater than 0, no. So that is why immediately cursor is reached to the end of the simple if statement. So that is why this is displayed, and this statement is skipped. See, using this condition, I'm excluding this condition, I'm excluding the statement, I'm skipping the statement. So that is why this is simple if is called decision making statement. We are called, it is a decision making statement. Of course, if we give suppose 0, in the case of 0 again, 0 greater than 0 false, so that is why you will get end of the program. 0 greater than 0 false, then this will be displayed. Okay, and this is about here the simple if statement. So what is the drawback of this simple if here? If the condition is false here, if condition is false, it not perform any action here, not perform. So see, if I am giving 0 and negative numbers, it is not display anything here. That is the drawback here. So our aim is that even though condition will be fail, so we have to perform some operations. It should be perform some operation. So this is the drawback of simple, and it is one way decision. So how many conditions it is uses? Only one condition, and based on this condition only it is executed here. That's also, that is why it's a one-way decision also, simple if. Okay, and now coming to the second one, if else statement. So coming to the if else statement, so it is having here true statement block. So first if followed by some text expression, and after then some true statement block, and if it is false, some false statement black will be executed. So now here we have two options. The problem of simple if is solved in with if else. Why? Even though condition will fail, it performs some operation. So now how it will perform here? If it excludes the block if the condition is true, otherwise the else block is excluded, that's all. Okay, so now see here, I am taking here, if this condition is true, the if statements are excluded. If it is false, other statements. And after end of this, any one of the this 2 year, the other statements of the program will be excluded. Okay, and let us see the example of this if else here. So in this scenario, if suppose this is failure, if I am assuming that the input, the first condition will be failed, then automatically the else block is excluded. So in the else block I am writing here, it is negative number. For the same program here, so I have to find out the number is even, the positive or negative number, now I'm compile the code, see if I am giving minus 12, now it is negative number. Okay, and if I am giving 10, so if I am giving 10, now 10 is positive number. Okay, so now even though condition will be fail, or if condition is true or false, the statements are excluded. So if this condition is true, some statement is excluded. It is false, other statement is excluded. So that is why it depends on the two condition. So that is why it is a two-way decision statement here. Two-way decision means what? For the first time, if condition is true, some statements are excluded. If condition is false, else block statements are excluded. Okay, and here also some drawback. Sir, what is the drawback of this if else here? What is the drawback of if else? See, if I am giving my input, if I am giving my input like zero, so it will give negative number. This is the problem with the if else here. So actually, see, if first one is blindly, if it is verify the first condition, if this is true, okay, this statement is excluded. But if it is false, means what? Else block is excluted. Okay, I am giving zero. Zero greater than zero, is it true? No, else block. Then you will get negative number. But tell me, zero is negative number? No. And this is the problem we are facing with the if else. Okay, we are facing with the if else. Otherwise, see, I have to give one more example. So now my intention is that I have to find out the biggest of two numbers. I am reading two numbers, A and B. And after then, read the two numbers. Okay, scanf. %D %D, comma ampersand A, comma ampersand B. And next, if A greater than B, A is big. First, I am writing directly, I am writing A is big. Okay, I don't want to display B, printf. Again, B is big. Okay, and this is the end of the program. See, so I'm build and run the program. If I'm giving 12, two programs here, 12, 45. Now B is this, the 45 will be big. 45 will be big. Okay, otherwise I want to display the value here, percentage D is big. If A is big means what? I have to print A value. Similarly, in the place of B, I'm writing percentage D big, comma B. Now again, build and run the code. I'm giving 23 and some 100. Now see, 100 is big. Okay, 100 is big. Like 100 and 34 I'm giving here. Then 100 is big. So for the two cases here, if first one is the biggest number, it will display as it is. Second is okay. But what is the problem with this here? What is the problem here? So if I am giving both the two numbers as same here, 12 and 12, now tell me what is the expected output. So if 12 and 12 means what you will get output is 12 is big, but this is wrong here. So actually 12 and 12 means both two are equal. So the A and B are equal. So that is why. So in this scenario, if the first one will be failure, if first one will be fail, automatically the else block is executed, but it won't verify the proper meaning of the code here. Proper, it won't verify here. Compile just perform. If the condition is true, true block is executed. Otherwise, else block is executed. That's all. But it won't verify the actual meaning of the code. So how we rectify this? So to rectify this here, the next type of control flow statement is exist in the picture, that is nested if else. Okay, so the next type is this nested if else. Okay, so in the case of nested if else, see, nested means what? Using one if else inside the another if or else block is called nested if else. The syntax is like this here. So I'm using if expression inside the if, I'm using one if else block. Otherwise, inside the else block, I'm using if else. Both the two represents the same here. Both the two represents the same. So using if else inside the if block and using the if else inside the else, it's giving the same meaning, that is nested if else. Okay, so now how to give here, so how to give the example of this nested if else. So now in this scenario, what I am doing here, I want to take a, if suppose when both the two inputs are not equal, then I have to perform this operation. If A and B are not equal to 2 only, then I can perform this. Otherwise, here I am printing A and B are equal. So I'm printing A and B are equal. And let us see the execution. See, if first it is verify the A and B value, if both the two are not equal only, then it will verify this. Otherwise, if these two are equal, means else block is executed. That's all. But see why it is. Why it is here nested if else? I'm using here. I'm using if else is inside the if else. That is why it is nested if else. Okay, that is why it is nested if else. Let's compile the code. Giving two numbers 12 and 12. Now in this case, A and B are equal. A and B are equal. So otherwise, I'm giving 23, 45. Now 45 is big. Like this, it will satisfy all the test cases here. So now, in this case here, the problem of previous if else problem is solved. Why? Because even though if values are equal, it will tell here the proper meaning. If two values are different, then only it will display which is big or not. When the two values are equal means just it tells the A and B are equal. That's all. Okay, and this is about here nested if else. And I want to give the explanation for the number input is positive or negative or neutral for that also. Just I'm taking here one, declaring the variable n and read the number. Okay, after reading this number, just what I am doing here. So first of all, I am verifying if your input is not equal to 0. If input is not equal to 0, then again we are verifying if it is greater than 0, it is positive. So I'm writing percentage D is positive. The percentage D is in otherwise. It is negative. Okay. If suppose this is failure, if not equal 0 is fail means what? And the else flag. So that means else n value will be 0. Then here I'm writing printf. Okay, it is 0. Now build and compile the code. So I'm giving here 0 first. So 0 means it is 0. Like I'm giving first 12. So now 12 is positive. If I'm giving minus 12, so minus 15, then it is negative. Minus 56 is negative. So like this, we can rectify the solution of a if else problem. Okay. Now here I want to do the find out a biggest of three numbers by using this nested if else. So here just I'm initialize all the values like this directly. I don't want to read dynamically 20 some c equal to 1. So first I'm verifying if can a is greater than b, then and if a greater than c, then a will be the big. Then a will be the big. So then a is big. Else. So C is big. Okay, after this. So now see if this will be if first we have to verify here. If A is greater than B, we are verifying this condition is true. Again, we are verifying A greater than C. If both the true are true, then A will be the big. Otherwise, the C will be bigger. Otherwise, C will be big means what? So already in this scenario, A is bigger. So if it is fail means what? C is greater than A. So already B is greater than A is greater than B. So now C greater than A means what? C will be the big. That is why I'm writing. Okay. And what about in the else block? In the else block. Again, in the else. So I have to verify if suppose. Okay. If this will be failure, so if the A greater than B is fail means what? B is greater than C. So B is greater than A. Just we have to verify the remaining condition. If B greater than C, it is true. If it is true, printf B is big. Otherwise, printf. In this case also C is big. Okay. And now you see the execution. You will get it. A is big. What is A? A is 100. If suppose I am making this. So B is 200. Now 100, 201 means I think if you compile this here, you will get 200 is big. Okay. 200 means B is big. And instead of writing this ABs, you can also write with values. Already you know the procedure. Just now I have taken that. And here, so I'm taking some 1000. Now I'm compile the code. Now you will get C is big. Yes. So now this code is satisfied for all the test cases. Okay. But what is the drawback with this nested if else here? See, so first, if this condition is, if it is fail, means if this condition is failed, immediately it is going into the else block and it is verifying, is it B greater than C? Already by this condition, we know B greater than A and B greater than C. So now B is greater than C and B is greater than A means B is big. Otherwise, C will be big. Okay. But the problem is that here, the programmer, he or she may have confused with the number of open and closed braces used in the code here. So see, this is the problem here, the usage of open and closed braces. Okay, so that is why, so the usage of open and closed braces is the problem. So now to avoid this here, to solve this type of problem here, this is the problem here. It is the complex two. We have used here many open and closed braces, means it's a complex thing here. So to avoid this here, the else if ladders came into the picture. Okay, so the next type of control structure is else if ladder. Else if ladder. So what is else if ladder here? So else if ladder means we are arranging the else if ladders. Okay, we are arranging the else if ladders, the else if expressions here, arrangement of else if expressions like an ladder here. So basically, if it is if else, at the end of else again we are adding new more if statement. So that is why it is represents like a ladder here. See, so each else block again is associated with some if expression. So now see, if expression, some statement block, else if, some statement block, else if, statement block, like this we can use else if statement block. So like this we can use else if as a ladder here. So now, once if you see the flowchart of this here, so first it is verify this condition. If it is not true, then verify the second condition, like next, like this. First of all, if it is true means what? It can skip this and the statement one will be executed and reach to the end of the program. That's all. Okay. And the important point related to this else if is, so this else, after else, okay, this else part is, it's optional to use, it is not mandatory. You can use from if to else if also. Okay, no problem, no issues with this. Okay, else is optional here. So I have to give the same program here biggest of three numbers by using else if ladder. Okay, so now here, just first I am verifying, is it A is greater than B and A is greater than C? If it is true, then I am displaying percentage D is big. What is percentage D? A. Okay, otherwise if this condition is fail, so see, if A greater than B fail, if it is fail means what? B is greater than A. So once if it is B greater than A means it is not evaluated. It is assumed that overall expression is false. Then condition next one is just we have to verify B is greater than C or not. So that is why I'm writing B greater than C. Then if it is true, printf percentage D is big, comma B. Okay, and in the else part here I can write printf percentage D is big, comma C. That's it. Okay, percentage D is big. I'll now build the code, again run, then you will get here 200 is the big. 200 is big. Okay, like this, if I am taking, suppose 1000, if I am taking 1000 here, Now I am debug the code. Again 1000 is big. So if I am writing this is 10,000 suppose. Now 10,000 is big. 10,000 is big. Okay. So by this way, we can implement this same biggest of three numbers code by using what here? Else if ladder. So first it is verify this condition. And next, see how many conditions I am using here? 1, 2. So if we use more than two conditions, that is nothing but here, it's multi-way decisions. We are doing here multi-way decisions. So that is why it's a multi-way decision statement. Else if ladder is also called. Okay. So see, when actually we have these many types of statements, when we use efficiently, see, my application is only interact with only one condition, means use simple if. Your application will be depends on two condition, means use if else. Your application will be depends on two or more condition, means use else if ladder. So use else if ladder. Okay, and this is about here. Okay, this is about a biggest of three numbers using else if ladder. Okay, and once if it is finished here, once if this will be finished here, the next type of a control statement is a switch. The next type of a control statement is switch. Okay, so what is switch actually? The switch is, it is a multi-way or multiple decision making statement, and it is an alternative of else if ladder also. Okay, switch is an alternative of else if ladder, and the switch uses some test cases. It uses some test cases here, and the switch case check the value of an expression against some case values, and if the condition is matched with the case values, then control is transferred to the case expressions. So how this case switch expressions it is having here? It is having integer, character or enum type. Okay, so the switch expression now the switch expression should be integer, character or enum type here. Integer, character or enum type. Okay. Now let us see the syntax of switch here. The switch expression, some case expression one uses some statement block break. Case expression two, statement block break. Expression n, statement block break. And like it uses default also. Default and default statements break. So what is the need of these cases here? See, if this expression is matched with any one of the cases here, the corresponding case statements are executed. Okay. And now we can represent all the test cases with the case keyword. And what about these expressions? Expressions are, if this expression is integer type, all expressions are int values. These are integer values. If it is character types, these are. Okay. And never your this expression is float here. Always it is integer, character or enum type only. The switch expression is of the type. And what is the need of break? If I am not using this break, means what? So if suppose this expression is matched with the expression one, means statement block one, block two, block n, including the default, all are executed one by one. If suppose if your expression is it is equivalent to with this case two, so from this case onwards, all these statements are executed one after the other. Okay, so which is the drawback? It is nothing, not drawback here. So we can take this as advantage also. I will give that. So this is the working of your switch control statement. And the control, the flowchart of this switch is this here. So expression and it, the case and the case statements break. Okay. So break, it is, if we are using break means what, after executing this black one, immediately cursor is come out from the switch black. And that is the purpose of break here. Okay. Generally break is used inside the switch or inside the loops. So used to exit from the, it is used to exit from the loops or switch block. For that purpose, the break is used. Okay. And now, so while we are working with this switch here, we should remember some points. What are the points? So we can use any number of cases. Okay, like almost 256 cases, you can use, no problem. The case value must be of the switch expression type only. That means if switch expression is some character or integer, then case should be that only, and it should be literals here. Case value should be literals. It's not a variable. It is the important point. Okay, and case values must be unique. No repetition of case values here, and the switch expression must be this int enum char type. And each case statement can have a break statement, which is optional. So usage of break inside each every case statement is optional here. It's not mandatory. Okay. And what happened when control is reaches to the break statement, it jumps the control after the switch expression. That's all. So now, so once if control is reached to the break means it is exist from the switch expression. That is the need of break here. Okay, so what happened if break is not found? It execute the next case. It execute the next case. So the case values can be default, and which is also optional here. So the usage of default is also optional here. So according to your requirement, you can use default or otherwise not need. Okay, and these are the points related to the switch statement. Related to switch statement. And now here I want to give some example of a switch here. I want to give an example of a switch. So what is that example? What is that example? So my intention is that I want to display here, if I am reading one input, 1 2 3 4, like that. If I am reading input 1, just display one. So the digit equivalent word I have to display. So for that, just I am taking int n. Okay, so I am taking here printf. So enter your choice. N is our choice. So now switch. So here n is integer type. So that is why all the cases are, just I am taking only 1 2 for I am showing only the example purpose. So that is why I am taking only 1 2 3 cases. Just I am printing one, that's all. And after this I am using break. Case 2 is 3, and I can take here some default. Choose 1 2 3 only. Then I am debug my code. So now, so actually I want to read the n value. So that is why. Again, build and run the code. So my choice is 2, then I will get, if choice will be 2, then I'm getting TWO2. Okay. So if my choice is other than 1, 2, 3, if it is other than 1, 2, 3, if I'm giving 4, then the default case is executed. So it will display choose 1, 2, 3 only. So this is here, n is, it is integer type, so that is why I'm taking all my cases, test case, these cases are what, integer type, and this should be literals, not variable. You don't take a b like variables here, it should be literal, integer, constant or characters or something. Okay, so this is the example here. See, if I'm commenting this break, what happened here? If I'm commenting the break, so if I'm commenting the break means what? So if this, suppose I am giving input 1, 1 means what? The next case after 1, after it is satisfied this case 1, then from this case until the default case here, all statements are executed. So if I'm giving input, then 1, 2, 3, choose 1, 2, 3, 4, all cases will come. Okay, all cases will come. Otherwise, so I'm giving new line here, then you can understand. So I'm giving here 1. See, if I'm giving 1 means from 1 to all test cases expressions are executed. That is the problem with the break here. So compulsory, if there is no break, means all executed from the matching expression onwards. Suppose if I am giving, it is, I am giving 2 means what? It will display all the case value statements from case 2 onwards. See, you will get 2, 3, choose 1, 2, 3, 4 only. Okay, so now, so after matching this expression, then all the remaining cases are executed. That is the problem with this. So to avoid this, need break. Okay, now compile and run the code. I'm giving 2, then you will get only 2. You'll get only 2. Okay, okay. Now my intention is that I have to find out here, I have to find out that the given input is character or the given character is vowel or consonant. I want to find out that. So I want to find out the given character is vowel or consonant. And then to find the given character is vowel or consonant means the input is, the input is this char ch, and read the character, printf, enter the character. Okay. And after then scanf percentage c comma ampersand ch, I am writing it. Okay, and after reading this here, after reading this, I am writing ch and case. So we have here, generally vowel means what? Generally vowels are a, e, I, o, u. The vowels are a, e, I, o, u are called vowels. Okay, and of course I am giving capital A, I, o, u also. So that is why all small and capital A, I, o, u are vowels. So that is why if your input is, okay, some small a, so how we represent characters in single code, that is why I am taking this. Okay, and next I don't want to write anything here. like I have to take first all four cases here. I bo you. Okay. Now, if suppose this is true here, if and the one more thing is that if suppose your input is capital letters, so that is why I have to add the remaining like this. Okay, and then so once if it is reached to here, just I have to display it is, if it is reached to this here, so percentage C is oval comma what is your input here, cap CH, so that is like this, and at the end I am using break. Okay, so otherwise means default I am taking. So in the default case I am writing percentage C is consonant. Okay, consonant. Then see the code here, I am giving my input A, so A is vocal. So like this, if I am giving input, if I am giving input capital A, capital A is also vocal. So other than vowels, if it is other than vowels, I am giving some small d, then D is consonant. Then D is consonant. Like this, you get the output. So in this case, I am not at all use any printf statement inside each and every case here. So how it will work here, if suppose, so when if I am giving e means it is reached to this, so okay, this is equal, then after then it is having any printf statement, no, this statement, like it will execute it until to reach all the cases here, but I wrote only printf inside the u cases, so that is why it is executed. And after then break is there, then immediately terminated. And what about the default case? Default case means, so this expression is not matched with this AEIOU, so finally default is executed, that's all. Okay, so default is executed. So break is, it's mandatory, it is not optional to use inside the default also. Okay, so this is about here, the find out a given input character is vowel or consonant by using switch. Okay, and now see, we have to do some of the programs. Already this program is over. The given number is positive or negative, okay, it is over by using the simple if else and nested if else also we did already, and I want to find out and the number is even or odd, so we have to see the code of this. I want to find out here the number is even or odd. So even means the number is, it should be divisible with 2, otherwise it's not. So generally in the case of C language, if number is divisible with 2 means what, you will get the remainder 0. So how to get the remainder here in the case of C language, using modulus operator. So first of all I have to read the number. Okay, printf, enter the number, scanf, percentage d, ampersand n. Okay, now here if this is divisible with 2 and you will get a remainder 0, then it is even, percentage d is even. What is percentage d here? N. Else. Percentage d is hard. Okay. Now I have to compile the code, build and run. I'm giving input here, 34. Now 34 is even. 34 is even. Similarly, if I'm giving a 3, now 3 is odd. 3 is odd. Okay. So this is the code. We are finding the input is even or odd number. Okay. And so using bitwise operators, find out the number is even or odd. So using bitwise, see here, just so without using modulus, find out the number is even or odd. The question is like this also. So in this scenario, we are applying the AND operation. Okay, with the 1, then you will get a remainder 0. And then if you are applying n and 1 and you will get a 0, then it is even. So let us compile and run the code. I'm giving 12. Okay, so n and 1. Now 34 is what? Even number. Okay, like if I'm giving the input 5 and 5 is odd. So I got the same output with the help of what here? Using bitwise AND. What is the logic here? Just applying the AND operation, bitwise AND with 1, you will get 0. Its value will be equal to 0, then it is even. If it is 1, it is odd. If it is other than 0, it is odd number. That's all. Okay. So now here I am not at all use any modulus operator here. Using bitwise AND, exclude the code. Okay. And next. So biggest of 2 numbers over, biggest of 3 also over. Find out given character is lowercase alphabet or uppercase or a digit or any special number. Okay, you can see the code of this. And if you want to find out, so the question is, we have to read one character and we have to tell them it is small alphabet, capital or digit or any special number. So that is why. So first of all, I have to read a character. So printf. Enter the character. Okay, and after then I'm using here percentage c comma ampersand ch. Okay, and after then, so if this character, generally the ASCII value of small alphabets are, okay, so either directly you can write in this scenario, you can write the code like this here. So if we represent, if your character is lies between small a2 and small z, or otherwise the ASCII values are 97 and 122, then it is small alphabet, and it is lies between capital A2 capital Z, otherwise 65 to 90 ASCII values, and it is lies from 0 to 9, or otherwise ASCII value is 48 to 57, then it is digits. And if your character is other than these three, it is a special character. We can treat like a special. So now see, directly I'm writing, if ch greater than or equal to 97 and the ch less than or equal to 122, then it is small alphabet. Small alphabet. it is greater than or equal to 65 and less than or equal to 90. Okay, so tick alphabet I'm ready. Next else. Okay, I can use one more condition. Suppose if it is lies between 48 and 57. Why the ASCII value of 0 is 48, ASCII value of 9 is 57. Digit. So otherwise it is special symbol. Now, so I am giving here small a, it is small alphabet. I am giving a, so I have to give some capital G, then it is big alphabet. Okay, it is big alphabet. So other than this, if I am giving a input like a 6 is digit. Okay, and I have to give a symbol called plus, then it is special symbol. Okay, special symbol. And this is here the solution for the OTA. It is the solution for, so this is the solution for the fifth one. The given character is lowercase or uppercase or any special alphabet. Okay, so now instead of taking this as 97, you can also write like this single code A. You can also write a single code Z. So it is capital A. It is capital Z. It's 9. It's a 0. Okay. So now I forgot to add one more single code here. Let us verify you are getting the same answer or not. I'm getting 4 digit. Okay. And this is also finished here. This one is also finished. And find out the name of the day from a week here. It's very simple here. Just I have to give the clue for this question. So just to take the cases like 1 to 7 or 1 to 7. So if case 1 means what, just to display it is Monday, and 2 is Tuesday, and 3 means like Wednesday. Like this you have to take 1 to 7 cases. And if your user is taking the choice 1 means print Monday to Sunday, you have to print all the values here. It's very simple. Okay, and now vowel or consonant is also over, and this is over. Next, find out year is, the given year is leap year or not. So see the question, we have to verify. So in this case here, we should follow these are the test cases, some test cases here. See, read the year from the keyboard, and if year 2012 is leap, 2013 is not leap, and 2100 not leap, 2400 leap. We should observe two scenarios here. See, if year is not a century year, not a century. Not a century means it's not divisible with 100 year. Okay, then we should when the year should be, the year should be divisible with 4, you will get the remainder 0, then it is leap. If whenever year is century year, year is century. Century means the year should be divisible with 400. Okay, when year is century year, it should be divisible with 400. Then only we are saying that it is leap year. Okay, so actually century year means it's divisible with 100. Non-century means it's not divisible with 100. So I don't want much focus much on this year. So most of the people, they are confused here. Just they are doing divisible with 4, they are telling. So otherwise, see, if I am giving 2100, so if 2100 by 4 means it is divisible, then some people, they are saying that it is leap. But you have to verify the calendar of this year. It is not a leap year. Why? Here, why we have to divide the with 400 means, for every 400 years, 3 times the leap year is skipped. So we have, suppose, 2000, 2100, 2200, 2300, 2400. See, if this is year, century year, so, and this is century year, and these two are century year, and here these two are century year as well as leap years. But between these year, 21, 22 are century years, but these are not leap year. So that is why we should divisible with the 400. So let us verify the code of this year. First of all, I have to read the code. So printf, enter the year, and after then scanf percentage d comma ampersand yr, I'm writing. Okay, so first of all, year is not a century, so that is why year percentage of 100 is it not equal to 0. This is one condition. Okay, and year not equal to 0, and year percentage of 4 is it equal to 0. Okay, now if this is true, if these two are true, or suppose year is century year, then it should be divisible with 400. Then it is leap. Otherwise, not leap. Okay, so first of all, this condition is for verifying century. If it is not century, then it should divisible with 400. And means what? Compulsory, these two. If this is true only, then it is evaluated. Otherwise, it assume that everything will be false. And again, so now once if it is false, again it is verify this with this 400. Why? Already this is fail means what? It is century year. Century year means divisible with 400. So let us verify for all the test cases. I'm giving first 2012 leap year, right? So I have to give 2013 not leap year. And next 2100 I am giving, so not leap year. Next 2400, it is leap year. Okay, this code is to satisfy for all the test cases here. All these test cases are satisfied. Okay, now coming to the last one here, implementing the calculator using switch. So implementing the calculator using switch means, so if I am taking here operators like plus, minus, division, multiplication and division I have to take. Okay, if I am using this plus, I have to perform the addition between two numbers. If I am using minus, perform the subtraction, multiplication, division, like that. So I have to take first two numbers, and after then I have to read the user choice. Then according to the user choice, perform the operations here. So for this reason, I have to take here two inputs, A and B. So that is why first of all I have to read the inputs here, enter the A and B values. Next, scanf, percentage d, comma, ampersand a, comma, ampersand b, I'm giving. Okay, after then printf, enter the character. Scanf, percentage c, comma, ampersand c, here. Anyway, here after reading these two number, after reading these two numbers, the what here, the buffer is filled with these two values here. So that is why, so I have to use here a flush. Then I have to clear the buffer by using this. Okay, now I am clear the buffer. After then, it is without any problem here, it is read the character. Okay, now so I have to take the test cases. What are the cases here? If case is plus, our expression is it is character type, so that is why I have to perform percentage d, comma, a plus b, then right break. So like this I have to take minus. Minus means it is minus. Next, multiplication. Next, division. Okay, and what about default? I can write default also. Just choose plus or minus or multiplication or division only. Okay, now build and run the code. I'm giving 12 and 45. Then I have to do the first. And I'm giving here, enter the actual operation it is. So now 57 will come. Okay, so instead of writing this, enter the operation operator I'm writing. So I'm giving 12 and 4. So I have to do the multiplication. Then I'm getting, okay, so 12, 4 is 48. So like this, we can implement here calculator program also. So I'm reading the two numbers, and it is for clearing the buffer here. It is for clearing the buffer. See, if we are not using this means automatically. So after reading the two numbers, so the default is executed. That's all. So now after this, automatically default is executed. So that is why we have to clear the buffer by using this fflush stdn. Okay, now, and this is the all the programs here. We are working with this control flow statements, and I have to give one task for you. The task is this here: find the product of max and the middle of the given elements here. Like input is this 6 to 3. So input 6 to 3 means what is the maximum number? 6. And what is the middle number? If minimum number will be 2, otherwise you can take this 2, 3, 6. Okay, so now see, from this here 6 is the max and 3 is the middle number. So 3, 6, the output 18 will come. And if you take an year 12, 34, 5, 12, 34, 5, maximum is this, middle is 12, 12, 34, 408. Okay, so I'm giving this program is assignment for you. And do you have any doubts related to this task? Comment me and message to me, so I will provide the solution, and I will give the solution of this in the next upcoming video. Okay, and thank you for watching this video.